Hello friends, in this video, in this lesson, we are going to see the ABM unit 7 and the name of the unit is the economic reform. See friends, this unit is only a small unit, which is a small unit and the complete theoretical unit. So let's see some introduction part. That means what we have to see, we have to observe the economic reforms in the world and the mainly in the India. See, Indian economy has the seen a steady growth. That means our Indian economy is good going mainly after 1991. That means in 1991 when LPG reforms were adopted, that is liberalization, privatization and the globalization, that's why the FDI was allowed in India and many private players also allowed. That's why our economy boom, and that's why we can say our economy has grown good growth after the 1991. So that is the some basic idea. So friends, we are just taking the overview of this unit because IIBF is generally asking very less question from this unit. So we will take some brief overview so that you will get some confidence, and we will also see some important bits so that you can easily attempt the MCQs. What we have to study is the reasons for the transformation of the Indian economy, economic transformation in the various sectors, issues of the Indian economy and the what is the way forward that we have to study. So see friends, transformation of economy. We all know after the post independence, India has adopted mainly the mixed economy. Mixed economy, that means we are having the private as well as the public sectors, right? But after 1991 reform, our many sectors which are closed sector, that are mainly for the government sectors, are allowed to operate freely. That means the private players are allowed and foreign direct investment is allowed. That's why after the LPG reforms in 1991, our economy has getting boom in the boom phase. That means we are observing the good growth, right? But we have to see some important collapse, that is collapse of the USSR, that is the USSR, that means the old Russia. Why the old Russia collapsed? Mainly because we all know there was the Cold War between the Russia and the United States of America. That's why during the Cold War, the Russian government has infused their lot of money in the weapons. That's why their national savings becomes narrow. That means their national savings become down. And that's why their economy got collapsed, and when that also resulted in the collapse of the East European socialist regime. That means the neighboring countries of the Russian, that also got collapsed because they was their main leader was the Russia. When Russia is a fail, that's why their morale of all the countries were down, and they also felt that the ideology and the followings of the Russia are not good. And that's why the collapse of the East European socialist regimes happens. And one important thing we have to remember, why the Indian economy is also standing in such a circumstances. Mainly because in India there is emerging regional parties. That means in India there is mainly a national party as well as the regional parties also. That's why we are having the importance of the regional parties in the national politics. Second is the coalition government. That means the many coalition government has formed after 1990. We can observe, right? That's why it also helped that to sustain the economy. And as third is the market oriented reform, very very important. We have adopted the market oriented reform. That's why we can sustain easily in the global market. Next, what we have to see, the economic transformation in the real sector. What do you mean by real sector? That means we can say the core sectors, right? That means the sector which are mainly very important for the government, or which are mainly controlled by the government, we can say. That is the transformation in that sector we have to observe. So main important observation here. See friends, we have to take only brief overview of this unit. You can read, if you want to go through the detail, you can read through the notes that I will be providing you. But see some overview. Very first, the main reform is the abolishing the monopoly and restrictive trade practice, that is MRTP Act. in 1969, that was act was enacted, but that was abolished. What you have to remember, the full form, that is the Monopoly and the Restrictive Trade Practices, MRTP Act 1969 was abolished. Why that was abolished? To open the market, because due to this act, if you want to do the business more than 100 crores, then you need to take the permissions from the government. That was the provision in that act. So that was the main hurdle for the businessman. So that's why this act was abolished. That really helped to grow the Indian economy. Second is the foreign direct investment is allowed, as well as some import restrictions and the tax relief also given. So this is the basic. Next is the liberalization in the foreign direct investment. That means foreign direct investment is also allowed. So when we can say that the reform, that means the reform, whatever the reforms we are doing, that are really impacting the industry sector, and that will resulted, that is resultant mainly in the upgradation of the technology, that is increase in the efficiency, and the merger and acquisition, so that lead to compete globally, that lead to compete globally. So now what we have to see, the impact of real sector transformation on IT and the services. In the previous chapter we have studied that the services sector is a contribution according to 2008 and 9 data GDP is almost 64% of the contribution, and service sector is also called as a tertiary. Due to this, the IT industry in India was in the initially it was not that much of in the boom phase, but after the reforms the IT sector has been tremendously grown. That's why we can say the main major contribution in the service sector is mainly IT, banking and the insurance sector. Okay, now see some economic reforms in the financial sector, very important how the economic reforms were adopted in the financial sector. See, the transformation in the financial sector not only helped the service sector but also the manufacturing sector also. That means the whatever the reform they have adopted in the financial sector, it also helped the service as well as the manufacturing sector. And the important and notable thing we have to remember for exam point of view is only here. See, here there were three main committees. Very first is the Narasimha committee 1992, and that committee mainly on the give the report on the financial sector reform. Again Narasimha committee 2, that gave the report on the banking sector reform. Remember, 1992 first committee on financial sector reform and 1992 second committee on banking sector reform. That you have to remember. There only they can frame a question for the one liner MCQ, right? And third, you have to remember SH Khan report. SH Khan report on the working group for the harmonizing the role and the operation of development of financial institution and the bank reform in the financial sector. So this was the third committee, that is SH Khan committee. That three committee you have to remember, and their report on that you have to remember. Now we have to see the impact of financial sector transformation. What is impact on the money market? So friends, what is a money market? You must understand before, you might have studied in your JIB that when the securities are traded very short term, that is up to 1 year, that market is called as the money market. And due to the money market reforms, the monetary authority, that means monetary authority, is able to modulate the liquidity in the system. The liquidity can be managed after the reform. That become easy to manage the liquidity. And after, there are some more you can read reforms through that notes that is provided to you on our Telegram channel. Nothing to explain more in that, so we'll move to the next. There are also some reforms in the foreign exchange market. I am not going to explain the detail because we are going to study all that in your very first module of your BFM, and that's why we will take the all detail in that part, right? Just remember, there are also reform in the foreign exchange market. After that, there are some reforms in the another sectors like capital market, credit market also. So for in the capital, what is capital market? where securities are generally traded over the period of 1 year. That is called as the capital market. So there were some reforms. You can read that reforms in the notes. That is not much difficult. Mainly the dematerialization of security. That means demat is allowed. There are different reforms you can observe. Before the reforms, there was a materialized form of the security. But after reform, they have allowed the dematerialized, that is demat account they have allowed. Next is the, what are the reforms in the credit market? That also we have to see, that you can read through the notes. The nothing more to explain. The important what I think is the payment system. They have also allowed major reform in the payment system, and that is important for your exam point of view. Because see, the developments in the payment system, what are the developments, what are the reforms in the payment system? Very first is the Payment and Settlement Act 2007 was enacted, right? And that gives RBI to power to regulate and supervise the payment and settlement system. Also, the free uses of other bank ATM was allowed. Due to this, the financial inclusion activity booms up. Right, that means the free usage of other banks ATMs was allowed in the payment system reform. Next is the CTS, that is the check truncation system was introduced. CTS, that is the clearing, electronic clearing services, ECS is introduced. Next is the NEFT system was introduced. RTGS system was introduced. You have to remember the full form. They may ask for a half mark. Next is the Clearing Corporation of India, that is CCIL, was created. That was some major reforms. Then trade liberalization. In a trade liberalization, many reforms were adopted. That means, for example, ease of license, that is de-licensing of the intermediaries in the input. That means mainly the licensing system was for the getting license in the businesses was that is, we can say in nowadays, ease of doing the business, that was allowed. So the next important thing is the foreign direct investment. How that we have already studied how the foreign direct investment is allowed, and in certain sector in India right now there is 100% foreign direct investment is allowed. So next you have to remember the full form of the ECB, that is the external commercial borrowing. So you can read that all stuff you want through the notes. I am not going to explain it, each and everything in detail, because they are not generally asking the question on that, right? What are the main issues of the Indian economy? We are having issue of poverty, health, education, and social economic development. The important thing in the poverty you have to remember, see, the poverty is measured by the Gini coefficient, GINI. That coefficient is used for the measurement of the poverty. That is important. That is very, very important for the MCQ point of view. And we are having problem of socio-economic development. We are having health issues, right? The education system is also the big challenge in Indian economy. And what is the way forward to it? We are having different issues of Indian economy, and what will be the way forward? For agricultural, I have already told in the previous module that we are having urgent need of the second green revolution. And we all know that agriculture has contributed only 17% in the GDP, and more than 52% of our employment is only provided by the agriculture sector. And next is the some labor reforms we have to study, how the labor reforms help in the economic reforms, economic growth. Mainly we need to understand, and we need to protect the workers in the unorganized sector. Mainly the workers where there is no unions, that their rights should be protected. And so that for them, we need to provide some insurance, pension scheme, and a medical facility, etc., etc. That is the basic. You can easily read these notes and you come to know. But the important thing that I want to tell you, the concept is the demographic dividend. What do you mean by demographic dividend? Mainly, we are having the age group of 50 to 64. That means mainly the working group in our population is having the highest contribution. That means if we are having 100 peoples in our country, then 64 almost 60% of the people of our country are working. That means we can say we are the young country, and that is nothing but the demographic dividend. Okay, and next is the financial inclusion. I think I don't need any thing. I should not explain to you what is the financial inclusion. Next, how can the question can be framed from this unit? Because see, this unit is a very easy unit. You can just read the notes. And important thing is that IIBF is generally not asking question from that unit. So though I am making some important bits here, so that you will come to know, get idea about the basic of this unit, so that if IIBF ask the question, you can easily attempt that. See, for what type of question IIBF can ask, which of the following is not an outcome of the process of privatization? That means if you are following the privatization, which of the following will not be the output? Very first, opening of public sector to private sector. Yes, it is the output. Entry of private firms in the areas reserved for the public sector. Yes, it is. Moving away from democracy, it is not right. That is, it is not the feature that feature of the privatization. Converting public sector to private sector. Yes, it is the feature of private sector. Next, which of the following entity does not determine the exchanges? Government, market, RBI, ministry. RBI, government, and the ministry are the part of the regulator. So only the market is not the determining the exchanges. Next is the the summary. The main thing is only in 1991 we have adopted the LPG reforms, and that resulted in the higher growth of the India. That is mainly Indian GDP. And after the reforms like the RTGS, NEFT, commercial paper, certificate of deposit has been introduced. And obviously after that, what we have to study? We will see some important bits. What are the chances that they can ask a question from that? Remember, in India, mainly reforms, the major reforms in India was in 1991, that is LPG reforms. And MRTP Act 1969 was abolished. The full form was the Monopolies and Restrictive Trade Practice Act, and Essential Commodities Act 1995. You can remember the year. Next is important, the Narasimhan Committee report, very first, that is mainly on the financial sector reform 1992, and Narasimhan Committee second report on the banking reform 1998. You have to remember that. That is most expected MCQ from this chapter, nothing else. And remember, CTS was started in July 2008, the CTS was started. And poverty is measured by Gini coefficient, GINI coefficient. And HDI, very important, HDI, that is the Human Development Index, is mainly the main contribution in the development of the Human Development Index is Dr. Huck from the Pakistan, and the Amartya Sen from the India, the great economist from India. Amartya Sen and the Dr. Huck, around 1990 they have evaluated that index, that is Human Development Index. This point you have to remember for exam point of view. And we have already completed the overview of the this unit. I have not given you all the details of this unit because the IIBF is not asking the question from that unit in the majorly. They are hardly asking one or zero question from that unit, one or zero question. So that's why I have taken this unit in brief. If you want to study in the detail, you can join our Telegram channel for the notes. The notes will be provided on the Telegram channel. So for that, you have to search on the Telegram at the rate CIBBZ, at the rate CIBBZ. So friends, join our Telegram channel for the notes and doubt clearing. So friends, happy learning and all the best.